Can you remember your favorite meal? I want you to imagine it in your mind, what it looked like, how it tasted. Now, imagine that you ate your favorite meal. Let's pretend that the meal was Alfredo pasta, the chewy noodles, the rich Alfredo sauce. Now, imagine that you ordered your favorite dish at a restaurant, only to learn afterwards that the Parmesan was actually sawdust. Yes, sawdust. This might sound like an exaggeration, but gross instances of food fraud happen every day in Canada. Good morning, honorable judges, lovely audience members, and fellow competitors. Today, I will argue that food fraud is a major concern and that the Canadian government can do more to prevent it. In this presentation, I will identify the root causes of food fraud. I will clarify the role the Canadian Food Inspection Agency should take in food fraud prevention, and I will give you, the consumers, some tips on how to avoid becoming victims of food fraud. Food fraud is the deliberate addition, replacement, alteration, or misrepresentation of food for economic gain. For example, farm salmon might be marketed as wild salmon, costing consumers and earning fraudsters more money, since wild salmon is more expensive than farm salmon. But food fraud doesn't just hurt your wallet, it also makes you sick. For example, you can get diarrhea, hives, headaches, asthma, or anaphylactic allergic reactions when manufacturers deliberately replace certain ingredients with others for economic gain. Food fraud is causing a decline in consumer confidence in the quality of food. The CFIA, or the Canadian Food Inspection Agency, estimates that food fraud could cost the global food industry between $10 and $15 billion per year. To combat food fraud, we need to understand the path that food takes to get from farm to fork. This intricate chain has many opaque areas which make adulteration and misrepresentation a simple task to those who cause food fraud. Food has a complex supply chain to reach consumers. This chain is made up of four major components: production, processing, distribution, and consumers. As Dr. Robert Hanner, associate professor at the University of Guelph, puts this, when you buy things caught in African waters, processed at sea on a Chinese vessel, sold to a Russian distributing firm, which then markets it in Canada, you can see where the opportunity for a disconnect comes in. Food fraud is causing a large amount of problems for the public. Food fraud has so many stops controlled by different people and different countries, all which have different standards. So there's no method to keep track of what standard our food is going under to wait before it gets to us. The more stops in the chain there are, the more opportunities there are for miscommunication or falsification of products. Food fraud thereby lies in the lack of transparency and traceability to monitor the supply chain. The endless opportunities given to fraudsters poses the question of whether the food industry is doing enough to safeguard the quality of our food. The answer to this question is no. The CFIA is a regulatory agency funded by the government dedicated to the safeguarding of food in Canada. Over the past few years, the CFIA has been getting reduced funding from the federal government. This has made it hard for the agency to work effectively. If the CFIA had more funding, it could, for instance, promote a homegrown Canadian invention designed to fight against food fraud. This invention, designed at the University of Guelph, is the DNA barcoding system, which allows food inspectors to identify any living thing. This invention has led to a system in Canada. This system, designed in 2005, is the DNA barcoding network, which allows the advancement of species identification and discovery through the use of DNA barcoding. The government often shoulders the blame for food fraud, but they aren't the only ones to blame. We, as consumers, can be proactive in avoiding fraudulent food. For instance, consumers can prioritize purchasing from local food sources instead of non-local ones. For generations, my family has been farmers and cattle owners. They have always made sure the products they produced reached consumers without the intervention of companies. Direct sourcing limits food fraud. The chain of production is completely transparent. Another way consumers can help prevent food fraud is by getting educated about better purchasing habits and local food sources. Canadians have less knowledge about the agricultural industry. The CFIA should start identifying commonly fraudulent foods on their website so that consumers can stay notified. In part, Canadian food fraud is caused by the opaqueness of the supply chain. This problem can be mitigated with the CFIA using DNA barcoding to monitor in closer detail, the CFIA providing education to the public on food fraud, and us, the public, supporting local farmers by buying produce directly from them. This can create a system to prevent food fraud. Now back to the Alfredo pasta. What if I told you we could have a world where you wouldn't have to worry about your Parmesan being sawdust? Thank you.